Now, we will, after solving these examples, we will talk little bit about time constant. We have already seen in this example that if time constant is less, this transient in the circuit will decay faster, or we will say that circuit is faster. Now, suppose we will study with the help of one example only. Suppose this has initial voltage V0 and the switch is closed at t equal to 0 and this resistance is R. So, we will say that the capacitor voltage will vary like this, V0 into e to power minus t divided by tau, and capacitor current will be V0 by R into e to power minus t divided by tau, and we will say that tau is equal to RC. If we draw graph for capacitor voltage, capacitor voltage will look like this graph, and this will be asymptotic to V equal to 0. So, in this graph we will say that this circuit will always be in transient, or mathematically we can say that the circuit will go to a steady state at t equal to infinity only by the definition of a steady state. So, suppose, or then in this case we can say that starting from this point circuit is in transient and it is moving towards a steady state. So, we will say that the transient of this circuit is decaying time to time, and at mathematically at t equal to infinity the whole transient of this circuit decays. So, starting from V0, suppose after some time the voltage becomes, the capacitor voltage becomes V0 by 2. So, we will say that V0 minus V0 by 2, this much transient has decayed, or V0 divided by V0 by 2, because the total transient is of V0. So, if we calculate in terms of percentage, we will say this much percentage of transient has decayed. So, in this case we will say that the 50% of transient has decayed. So, I was just trying to explain the meaning of decay of transient. So, we will okay. Now, if we see the equation of Vc, the circuit is in transient state. If we put t equal to t tau starting from 0, if we want to analyze how much percentage of transient has decayed after t equal to tau, if we put t equal to the time constant of the circuit, then how much percentage of transient will decay. So, if we put t equal to tau, we will say that now the capacitor voltage is V0 into e to power minus tau divided by tau, which is equal to V0 divided by e, where e is equal to approximately 2.7. So, we will say that starting from V0, if we put t equal to tau, suppose this is t equal to tau, now the capacitor voltage is V0 divided by E, approximately V0 divided by 2.7. At this point the capacitor voltage is V0 divided by E. So, we will say this much transient has decayed. Now, V0 divided by E is approximately, this is, I do not have calculator now. So, as I remember this is 0.362 V0, this point is 0.3682 V0. So, this length will be 0.632 V0. So, we will say that starting from V0, the full transient is V0 and this much transient has decayed. So, if you want to calculate how much percentage of transient has decayed. So, this will be 6.632 V naught divided by V naught into 100. This will be 63.2%. So, we will say that in one time constant, if we put T equal to tau, that means one time constant, we will say that 63.2% of transient has decayed. So, this is a, so we can define time constant. Time constant is a time duration in which 63.2% of transient decays in a first order circuit. It is not necessary that decaying transient means a value of voltage goes to 0. If we talk about RL circuit, suppose this is V, R and L. If we write down equation for inductor current, this will become as, this will come as V divided by R into 1 minus e to power minus t divided by tau, where tau is equal to L by R. Now, if we draw graph for I L, in a steady state, the value of I L will be V divided by R. So, this is the steady state value. The circuit has to come to this condition and initially inductor current is 0. So, as the time will grow, the circuit will move from transient condition to steady state condition. So, at t equal to infinity, whatever is the value of inductor current will be called as steady state current. So, we will say that initially the inductor current was 0 and a steady state inductor current was, current is V divided by R. So, suppose at this instant, so we will say that the transient is decaying, as the inductor current is increasing, the transient is decaying. So, it has to, the inductor current has to move from 0 to V divided by R. Suppose it has moved to this much value, it has to move to V divided by R, the total transient, we will say that the total transient in inductor current is V by R. Suppose the inductor current has become this much value, suppose this is some value. So, we will say that this much transient has decayed. And now, if you want to calculate percentage in the decay of transient, we will divide this value by the total transient into, we will multiply by 100. So, if suppose in this equation also, we want to find out how much percentage of transient decays if we put t equal to tau, I L equal to V divided by R into, I am just finding out the value of inductor current at t equal to tau. This will be minus tau divided by tau. So, this will be V divided by R into 1 minus e to power minus 1. So, if this is tau, the value of inductor current, this current is equal to V divided by R into 1 minus e to power minus 1. So, this much transient has decayed in one time constant. Now, if you want to calculate the decay in the transient in terms of percentage, we will divide it by V divided by R, the full transient. This is full transient. V divided by R into 1 minus e to power 1 divided by V minus V by R into 100. So, if you calculate it, we will again get 63.2%. So, this is the definition of time constant, that in one time constant, the transient decays by 63.2%. And if we try to calculate the time in which 100% of transient will decay. So, 100% of decaying, 100% transient means the inductor current will become V divided by R. If we put V divided by R here, we will get, this is cancelled, we will get e to power Here it will be 1 equal to 1 minus e to power minus t divided by tau. So, we will get e to power minus t divided by tau equal to 0. And since tau is positive, we will have to put t equal to infinity. So, we will say that mathematically at t equal to infinity, the full transient will decay, but this is not the practical case. Now, if in the same equation, we put t equal to 4 tau, the inductor current at any time is equal to V divided by R into 1 minus e to power minus t divided by tau. Now, if we put t equal to 4 tau, so this will be V by R into 1 minus e to power minus 4. Now, if you will calculate this value, you will get approximately 2% of V by R, that is 0.02 V by R. If we put t equal to 4 tau, suppose this is 4 tau, you will get 98% of V by R. So, here you will get this value. Not 2% of V by R, this will be 98% of V by R, this is 0.98 of V by R. So, this length is 0.98 V by R. So, we will say that this much transient has decayed. So, now if you want to calculate in terms of percentage, the decay in transient 0.98 V by R divided by total transient into 100. So, this will be 98%. Similarly, if you put t equal to 5 tau, you will get approximately, if you put it 5 tau here and calculate with the help of calculator, you will get e to power minus 5 here. So, you will get approximately 0.99 V by R. So, we will say that after 5 time constant, 99% of transient decays. So, we can also say that 99% of transient decays after 5 time constant. Now, if I ask you after how much time 100% of transient will decay, the time will suddenly be infinite. We have already calculated it. Now, what is the typical value of time constant? The typical value of inductor is, if I write inductor is equal to 1 millihenry, this is a large value of inductor. This is not a small value of inductor. 1 millihenry is a large value, 10 millihenry is even larger, and 1 henry is not practically possible. The size of inductor with this value will be a size, is equal to will be a size of a room. So, this is a very high inductor. This is not practical value. So, if we put the highest, even if we put the highest value of inductor 10 millihenry and lowest value of resistance 1 ohm, the time constant will be 10 millihenry divided by 1, this will be 10 millisecond. Now, after 5 time constant, 99% of transient decays, or if we multiply it, I have taken the lowest value of resistance and the highest value of inductance. So, this time constant is large. So, the large value of time constant is 10 millisecond. So, the 5 tau will be 50 millisecond. So, we will say that 99% of transient decays after just 50 millisecond. 50 millisecond is still very less time, and for 100% for transient, the time taken by transient to decay by 100%, this is infinite time. So, to decay a difference of 1%, it takes infinite time, and to decay or we will say that to decay 99% it takes just 50 milliseconds, and to decay further 1% of transient it takes infinite time. So we will say that if 99% of transient has been decayed, we are satisfied. We will say that okay, approximately the whole transient we assume that the whole transient is 99%. If 99% of transient is decayed, we are satisfied and we can say that the whole transient has decayed. So we will say that the whole transient decays in 50 milliseconds or in 5 tau. So it depends, somewhere in question it will given that the settling time is the time in which approximately 99% of transient decays, or we will say that the time taken by 99% of transient to decay will be called as practical time constant, and the time taken by resistance to decay by 99% will be called as practical settling time, TS practical. TS is the time for the circuit to come in a steady state, but mathematical settling time will always be infinity. So, we will say that in one time constant, transient decay by 63.2%. So, this is obviously not the settling time. After 4 time constant, transient decay by approximately 98%. After 5 time constant, the transient decays by approximately 99%. So, in some cases, the practical settling time is taken as 4 time constant, and in other cases, the practical time constant is taken as 5 time constant or 6 time constant, depending upon the question. So, in the question, it will be given at this will be given as what type of formula you have to take for settling time constant, settling time. And time constant is for RC circuit, time constant is equal to R equivalent into C, and for inductive circuit, this is L divided by R equivalent. So, this is the significance of time constant, and in the example I have already shown that if the time constant is less, suppose this is the time constant, the definition of time constant is that the time in which 63% of decay, 63% of transient decays. So, if this is the time constant, the 63% of transient means this height. So, the current have to reach 63% of transient decay and transient in this much time only. So, the graph will be like this. Now, if you compare these two graphs, this graph looks faster. If time constant is more, suppose this is time constant, so in this much time, the decay and transient will be equal to this height. So, in this time, the inductor current will be, the graph will be like this. So, if you compare these three graphs, this graph is the fastest. So, if time constant is less, graph is the transient, the decay and transient is faster, and we will say that the circuit is extreme, the circuit is fast. We will solve more numericals, I will make separate videos, more videos for numerical on this topic, because these topics are very important. And for example, if we talk about this topic, this is the base of control system. If we talk about the question in which there will be some question in which before t equal to 0 the situation will be given, and after at t equal to 0 plus the situation will be asked. So, this type of question oftenly comes in GATE. So, we will practice more for this type of problems, and I will solve more questions in the video lecture.